You are listening to TBR Radio Presents, The Dixie Heritage Show, with your host, the director of Dixie Heritage, Dr. Ed DeVries.
The day of our destiny was darkened. The heart of the nation stood still when Forts Henry and Donelson surrendered and Johnston fell back to Nashville. But the clouds which then thickened all around us served only the plainer to show the form of that hero arising to deliver us all from the foe. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. In our hearts he will triumph forever. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. At Shiloh he charged a division and covered our army's retreat. At Murfreesboro won his promotion when Crittenden admitted his defeat. Next straight went careering before him, expecting our rear to assail. But Forrest with his fair maiden pilot soon landed the robber in jail. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. In our hearts he will triumph forever. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Chickamauga, Chattanooga, Oklahoma, Memphis and Tishomingo Creek, Union City, Fort Pillow and Paducah, all the deeds of our hero bespeak. Now Athens, Sulphur Springs and Pulaski have aroused old Sherman from his lair. For the boldest of Yankee commanders will tremble with Forrest in his rear. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. In our hearts he will triumph forever. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Next, Johnsonville attracted his attention, where Sherman had collected his stores. And the gunboats, once terrible to mention, floated grandly and proudly at his doors. But Forrest's artillery battalion, Morton, Rice, and Walton, and Prawl, set fire to Sherman's gunboats and transports, nor ceased till they had burned them all. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. In our hearts he will triumph forever. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. In our hearts he will triumph forever. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee.
That was Bobby Horton from his album Homespun Tunes of the CSA. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee, a tribute to Lieutenant General Nathan Bedford Forrest. At the time that I'm recording today's show, General Forrest's bust is being removed from the State House in the Tennessee Capitol. General Forrest was a great man, but after the war, he converted and he was greatly used of the Lord. A lot of the history that we hear about Forrest is not true. Nathan Bedford Forrest rose from a private soldier to the rank of lieutenant general in the Confederate Army. He's the only person in the history of American warfare to have ever enlisted in the army as a private and rose to the rank of lieutenant general. He was acclaimed for being a self-educated, valiant, and brilliant cavalry leader. Prior to the war, he was an affluent planter, a real estate backer, and yes, a slave trader, and that is probably why there is so much negativity surrounding him and why there are such great efforts to tear down his monuments and his statues. Despite lacking a military education, Forrest rose to the high ranks because of his innate strategic and tactical abilities. He pioneered naval policies for mobile forces. Much of what he was doing in horse warfare is being duplicated today by armies in tank warfare. He earned the title the Wizard of the Saddle. He was also called the Devil in the Saddle. Was it General Sherman, the Union general, who called him that? Devil Forrest. And so one of the recruiting slogans of the day was Ride with the Devil. But Forrest was a brilliant war between the states hero. He was the quintessence of bravery and decisiveness. He is someone who I recommend young men model their lives after. Why? Because he always led from the front. He did what he said he was going to do. He took care of his people. And his people included both races. General Forrest is one of our heroes. But we need to break for a commercial now. 45 seconds. A word from our sponsors, the Barnes Review. And we'll be back with more of the Dixie Heritage Show.
Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. In our hearts he will triumph forever. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee.
Open your web browser and type in www.barnesreview.org and discover the Barnes Review magazine. In the Barnes Review, you will read vignettes of man, from the prehistoric to the very recent, from forgotten races and civilizations to first-person accounts of World War II and the late Cold War. There is no more interesting magazine published today, nor a more significant and important subject than real history. So visit www.barnesreview.org and subscribe to the Barnes Review. You can subscribe to receive the Barnes Review magazine in its print form, or in convenient electronic delivery. Our host has been a subscriber to both formats for years. So visit www.barnesreview.org and subscribe to the Barnes Review.
Well, we all thought there was just one national anthem, the Star Spangled Banner. You know, they always begin the baseball game asking Jose if he can see. Well, apparently there's a national anthem for black people. I guess we're about to find out what it is, because the NFL commissioner reportedly has announced that they're going to start playing it before NFL games, hoping that that will clear up the whole mess of whether people should kneel or stand or, you know, do whatever. My personal suggestion, at least for games that are played in the southern states, is that we play the real national anthem of our Southland. Take your hat off, boys. Show some respect.
God save the South. God save the South. Her altars and firesides. God save the South. Now that the war is nigh, now that we arm to die, chanting our battle cry, freedom or death. Chanting our battle cry, freedom or death. Now that the war is nigh, now that we arm to die, chanting our battle cry, freedom or death. Chanting our battle cry, freedom or death. God be our shield, at home or afield, stretch thine arm over us, strengthen and save. What though they're 3-1, forward each sire and son, strike till the war is won, strike to the grave. Strike till the war is won, strike to the grave.
Now that the war is nigh, now that we arm to die, chanting our battle cry, freedom or death. Chanting our battle cry, freedom or death.
Extra, extra, read all about it.
If you're like me, and I'll bet you are, you like to be on the cutting edge of honest news and accurate information. 26 times a year, the American Free Press newspaper can be delivered to your door, packed with the kind of uncensored news that I know you're going to appreciate. If you're ever dissatisfied with your subscription to the American Free Press, their guarantee is that you just drop them an email and they will gladly refund the unused portion of your subscription. So what are you waiting for? Visit www.americanfreepress.net. Once again, www.americanfreepress.net. And find out about the American Free Press. Do it today.
Extra, extra, read all about it.
Here's another great song on Bobby Horton's Homespun Songs of the CSA, the lyrics of which inspired many a brave man to join the cavalry and to ride with General Forrest.
Sons of the South, arise, rise in your matchless might. Your war cry echo to the skies, God will defend the right. Let haughty tyrants know our sunny land shall be, in spite of every foe, home of the brave and free. Sons of the South, arise, rise in your matchless might. Your war cry echo to the skies, God will defend the right. Our flag shall proudly stream, defiant of assault, with bars of the rainbow's brightest beam and stars from the heaven's blue vault. Thousands of true and brave, their hero lives may end. Over thousands that flag shall wave, and thousands its folds defend. Sons of the South, arise, rise in your matchless might. Your war cry echo to the skies, God will defend the right. No wrongs our breasts alarm, no fears our hearts appall. Unswerving justice nerves our arm, we cannot conquered fall. Think on our noble sires, immortal in renown. Think on our altar fires, and strike the oppressor down. Sons of the South, arise, rise in your matchless might. Your war cry echo to the skies, God will defend the right. With threats of horror's dire, the fierce invader comes. We scorn his boast, we scorn his ire, striking for hearts and homes. Strike for our of the South, arise, rise in your matchless might. Your war cry echo to the skies, God will defend the right.
I'm on the phone again with Dr. William Von Peters, who has been my personal doctor for the last 10 years. For whatever reason, people are afraid of COVID, or if they're not afraid of COVID, they're They're definitely afraid of catching something right now. I think with all the hysteria in the media, all the hype that's been built up, people are just afraid of catching something. And you were telling me the other day that you have a product there in your line, your homeopathic line, that was an immunosystem booster. Not really a drug, but just something that we would take. It's a natural formulation that would help boost our immune systems and decrease our chances of catching all of the things that are supposed to be out there right now. So why don't you just tell us a little bit about that?
Now, we do have a formula that I designed based off of the symptomology they were saying. Because homeopathy, you know, the philosophy is like cures like. And whereas allopathy, which is what the MDs use, is opposite cures. So, you know, if you have something that, for example, if something's too hot, you give something that would cause a heat in the body, and it will tend to dissipate the heat then. You know, such as coffee on a hot day is an example of that in real life. But anyway, so, you know, we have some things. I have to develop one called Corona Quest, which is basically covers the, you know, all the symptoms they were claiming that the that it has, primarily just as a preventive to help the body hopefully be able to recognize the coronavirus. We don't make, and none of our products do we make medical claims for. You know, it's just to assist the body in healing and being able to heal itself. Because if you start making medical claims, then of course they're going to come after you. So, like the Corona Quest, it's designed to assist the body in recognizing the coronavirus and strengthening the immune system against it. But we make no medical claims for it.
And so if somebody wants to get a bottle of this and try it for themselves, what do they need to do?
Basically, just go to the website for a company, LifeQuest Formulas. And so that would be LifeQuest Formulas, that's plural, LifeQuestFormulas.com.
All right, LifeQuestFormulas.com. And for our radio listeners who happen to be watching on YouTube, that'll be on the screen as well. You'll want to go to LifeQuest Formulas and you'll want to check this out, and you'll want to check out some of the other homeopathic products that Dr. Von Peters is offering there as well.
Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee. In our hearts he will triumph forever. Here's to Forrest from the brave Tennessee.
As I said earlier in today's broadcast, General Forrest did not convert. He did not become a Christian until after the war. During the war, he was a very rough man. But his wife was a very genteel Christian lady. She was of the mind that where her husband went, she would go. And so, much to his displeasure, not that he did not enjoy having his wife with him, he did, but it often put her in danger that he would have rather not put her in, to please his wife, who, as I said, was a saintly Christian lady. He would have the chaplains preach in their camp, their army camp, every night. And a great revival swept through the Southern armies. This song, another from Bobby Horton's Homespun Songs of the CSA, was a hymn often sung around the campfires in Forrest's camp, a prayer of the Confederate soldier.
Southern land. spirits that battle for the right. Clothe them in heavenly armor with more than human might. Give them the Holy Spirit to bear our cross on high, that through its sacred merit they win.
Phone with our good friend Clint Lacey. So your newest project is you've started a publishing company, Foothills Media, and you'll be publishing three tremendous books. The first of those is your book, The Beginner's Guide to False Flags. Why don't you tell us just a little bit about that book?
If you were wondering how we ended up at this point in our history and everything's going on, Beginner's Guide to False Flags takes you from the beginning of the country until the election of Donald Trump, Charlottesville, the rise of the communists, and the Russian collusion hoax. The rape of Delaware County is a story in which a United States veteran defended himself against a known drug felon, only to find out that the local police were in on it. Crooked prosecutors, and one of those prosecutors was actually arrested coming back from an island in the Caribbean in a murder-for-hire plot. And it just details just how corrupt one small county can be. And in the book, I said that Delaware County, Oklahoma, in the past was a safe haven for outlaws from Missouri and Arkansas. And what the reader will find out, it still is. Blood in the Ozarks, expanded second edition, 156-year-old government cover-up in which out-of-control Union officer led his men to murder men, women, and children at a Christmas gathering in the Missouri Ozark. I found it Foothills Media in 2019 because I'm dedicated to bringing you the truth.
Thank you, Clint. I know that our listeners are going to want to check out Foothills Media, so tell them how they can do so.
Well, you can visit us at foothillsmedia.net, and that will take you to our website where you can browse the books, read our blog post, and catch up on news that you won't find anywhere else in the mainstream media. Foothillsmedia.com.
Here's the forest from the brave Tennessee. Here's the forest from the brave Tennessee. In our hearts he will triumph forever. Here's the forest from the brave Tennessee.
Older, wiser, and Christian General Forrest in his retirement may or may not have approved of this next song. But remember that during the war between the states, he was still that devil Forrest. And this was the song that made a lot of young men want to ride with the devil.
The devil, if you want to have fun, if you want to smell hell, join the cavalry. We're the boys who went around McClellan, went around McClellan, went around McClellan. We're the boys who went around McClellan, bully boys, hey, bully boys, oh. Went to Pennsylvania, went to Pennsylvania.
say. Bully boys, ho, if you want to have a good time, Johnny Cavalry, Johnny Cavalry, Johnny Cavalry. If you want to catch the devil, if you want to have fun, if you want to spill hell, Johnny Cavalry. Then the big fat Dutch gals hand around the breadium, hand around the breadium, hand around the breadium. The big fat Dutch gals hand around the breadium. Bully boys, hey, bully boys, ho, if you want to have a good time, Johnny Cavalry, Johnny Cavalry, Johnny Cavalry. If you want to catch the devil, if you want to have fun, if you want to spill hell, Johnny Cavalry. Old Joe Hooker, won't you come out of the wilderness? Come out of the wilderness, come out of the wilderness. Old Joe Hooker, won't you come out of the wilderness? Bully boys, hey, bully boys, ho, if you want to have a good time, Johnny Cavalry, Johnny Cavalry, Johnny Cavalry. If you want to catch the devil, if you want to have fun, if you want to spell hell, Johnny Cavalry. If you want to have a good time, Johnny Cavalry, Johnny Cavalry, Johnny Cavalry. If you want to catch the devil, if you want to have fun, if you want to spell hell, Johnny Cavalry.
Well, once again, we are out of time for this week's TBR Radio Presents the Dixie Heritage Show. I hope that you'll go to our website, www.dixieheritage.net, www.dixieheritage.net. Check out our free weekly email newsletter. There are back issues right there on the website. And after you've read a few of those, or maybe after you've gone through the show archives and listened to a few back episodes of the Dixie Heritage Show, you'll use the contact form and you'll sign up to receive that free weekly email newsletter, the Dixie Heritage Letter. I email it out every Friday. And when you sign up, I'll also send you a free copy of my book, The Truth About the Confederate Battle Flag. You'll receive both absolutely free of charge, no cost or no obligation. Anyways, as I said, we're out of time, but let not your heart be troubled. We'll be back again next week, same time, same place. We'll have another great show for you. Until then, I'm going to leave you with one more song from Bobby Horton's Homespun Songs of the CSA. While not a tribute song to General Forrest, the loss of this song here in Maryland is a very saddening thing for all of us. And I know that General Forrest would have opposed the displacement of this great song as much or more as any Marylander would have. Bobby Horton, Homespun Songs of the CSA, Volume 1. The despot's heel is on thy shore, his torches at thy temple door. Sic semper tis the proud refrain, Maryland, my Maryland.
The despot's heel is on thy shore. She'll come, she'll come.